Hey guys, it's Bryony, and today I'm going to be telling you how to find your cervix. So this is a question I get asked quite a lot, and I have addressed it in other videos before, and in particular in a video I did many years ago now called How to Find Your First Menstrual Cup, but I've never given this topic its own video, and I really feel it deserves it because it is quite important when choosing a menstrual cup to know your cervix height. This is because the height of your cervix may affect which cup works best for you, so it's always a good idea to check your cervix height before you buy a menstrual cup. It's also important for me to note that your cervix can actually move up and down, so it's never fixed at one particular place. For example, when you're aroused, your cervix moves higher up so that it doesn't get beaten to death by a penis. And when you're on your period, it can tend to drop a little bit lower. But this isn't the case for everybody, so it's important that you check what's happening with your own body. So check your cervix height before you're on your period and also when you're on your period to see if there's any difference and to take that into account when choosing your first menstrual cup. So to help me demonstrate today, I'm going to be using this little piece of blue tack and this clear syringe. The blue tack is going to play your cervix in this scenario, and the syringe is going to be your vagina. So your cervix should kind of feel like a soft pea in a way, which is why I've used blue tack. And if I hold this up to the camera, you can probably see as well that I've punched a little hole there with a pen, the end of a pen. And this just gives it like this little nib bit, because when you run your finger over your cervix, you'll feel that it kind of dips in the middle. It's not like a solid circle. So that's why I've just punched this hole into this little piece of blue tack, is to kind of give more of a similarity to how a cervix would feel. Now, in my case, my cervix is actually about 2 knuckles deep on my index finger. So I'm going to place this piece of blue tack inside the syringe about 2 knuckles deep. So there we go, I've just squished it in there now. So now you can see that if I set my finger in here, when I'm about 2 knuckles deep, I can feel this soft squishiness in my cervix. And obviously when it comes to your vagina, this hard tube that is currently the syringe will actually be soft, warm tissue. So it will feel very different to using a syringe, but this is the closest I can get to a similarity. Oh, my blue tack's fallen down. So I've ended up kind of squishing this blue tack in here because it doesn't want to stick to my plastic vagina. But basically, what you need to do is first of all, wash your hands, make sure they're nice and clean. Then just sit on the toilet really relaxed or in a position that you find comfortable. Some people prefer to stand and put their leg on the toilet seat or on another sort of step. And then you simply take your index finger, insert it into your vagina, and just slowly work it around in circles like this until you come to the point where you feel your cervix. And trust me, you will notice it if you can feel it, because it feels very different to the tissue that makes up the wall of your vagina. It's a little bit firmer, it's a little bit harder than the vaginal walls, and also you'll feel this very distinctive sort of P shape with the dip in it that I showed you earlier. Now, everybody's body is different, so your cervix height may be much higher, in which case if I push this little bit of blue tack up a bit, now you can see if I insert my finger, I can't actually feel this bit of blue tack. This is what we call a really high cervix. Now, if you can get your finger in, but you can only just about touch it, which is here, then we say this is a high cervix. If you're like me, and you can get it in to about the second knuckle, this bit of blue tack does not want to play ball with me today, to about the second knuckle here, then we say this is sort of a moderate to low height cervix. And if you can only get one knuckle in, remove that blue tack there, so you can only get one knuckle of your finger in before you feel your cervix, that's a very low cervix. So this makes it quite difficult to use a menstrual cup, but anything from sort of 2 knuckles deep with a moderate to low cervix is okay for using a menstrual cup, but you will need to be careful which menstrual cup you choose. So to show you how your cervix height can affect which menstrual cup you use, I'm going to be using a ruby cup. This is my ruby cup, which I've cut the stem off of, and also this new size 2 or model 2 version of the lunette cup, which is a larger cup and it's also got its stem intact, as you can see here. So using my little syringe, I have just placed the blue tack at about 2 knuckles worth depth into the tube. Now, this ruby cup is my personal cup, as I said before, so this one works well with my body. Now you can see if I hold the syringe up so that you can actually see where the blue tack is and I place the cup next to it, you can see why I needed to cut the stem off of this cup. If it was any longer, it would poke out of my vagina and that would make it really uncomfortable. Now this is a plastic tube, so I can't insert the menstrual cup into it because it wouldn't open up. Your vaginal muscles are very stretchy, so they would open to accommodate the cup and sort of wrap around and hug it like this, which is what stops it from leaking. But if I were able to insert the cup, you would see that it can quite easily fit inside me because of the length of the cup, the rim is here. With your cervix, you can also sometimes sort of coax it into the cup. So sometimes if your cervix is sitting right here, you can kind of coax the cup around it so that it sits a little inside. This will affect the capacity a little bit, so do bear that in mind. You might not be able to wear a cup for as long if you've had to actually coax your cervix into your cup, but it shouldn't be too much. And either way, it means you can usually use a slightly bigger capacity cup to begin with and get it fully inside you. Now, if I take my larger lunette cup here with its stem intact, you can see that this quite clearly is not going to work for my body, because here is the piece of blue tack and here is the rim of the cup, but the stem is sticking out of the base of the tube here, which means this would be sticking out my vagina and that would be very uncomfortable and wouldn't be fitted correctly. If your cervix, however, was way up here at the top of the tube, you can see you can get this cup completely inside with no stem sticking out, and therefore this would be the right sort of length for you. Now, you can always trim the stem of your cup. So even if you get a slightly longer cup like this and you find that it's too long with the stem on, you can trim it off. But even this one, the actual cup itself is a little bit longer, so it probably wouldn't work for me as someone with a sort of low to medium high cervix, but with someone with a little bit of a higher cervix, it would be okay. This is why it's really important to check your cervix height, particularly on your period, because if you get a larger cup like this, and particularly if you get a longer bodied cup, you might find that actually you can't use it if you have a medium to low cervix, and particularly if you have a very low cervix, there's only a small number of menstrual cups that will work for you with that. But I hope you found this video helpful, guys. I hope this little demonstration kit gave you a better idea of what you need to look for when checking your cervix height, and also why your cervix is so important when choosing a menstrual cup. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Please subscribe. Don't forget you can get cough pads and menstrual cups, including both the models I showed in this video, on my website, Precious Stars. The link will be down below. Let me know what other videos you'd like to see and any other tips I can give you, and thanks for watching. Bye!